Also in limited theaters this weekend and available on demand is indie thriller California Scheming. We take a look at it right now on Bashing Hollywood. California Scheming is about three troubled teens in Malibu that end up meeting another troubled young teen from New York named Chloe. She's a manipulative psychopath who loves playing mind games and ruining people's lives. It is marketed as a thriller, and I guess that would be the most accurate description of it, but be forewarned that this is a rather slow thriller. It's more of the kind of slow burn variety, and not really a lot actually happens until the end. There are a lot of interesting ideas, but unfortunately, most of them are not fleshed out enough to really hit with the sort of punch that you would expect from a movie like this. I thought it was gonna be kind of more of like a mind-bending sort of thing, you know, where we were gonna get hit with like a major twist at the end, but that never really happened. It's sort of just kind of an utterance. It's just like, oh, well, this is why I did all of this, blah, blah, blah. And it's not really shocking or anything. It's kind of just nonchalant. Like I said before, there are some interesting ideas on display here. And I do think a great film could have been pulled out of this concept, but instead it kind of just comes off as thrown together. It's kind of like there's a lot of little things that end up in the movie that I feel like could have been cut out or didn't really serve any purpose other than to be there, and they sort of distract from the things that you are supposed to be focusing on, and then when those things come to fruition, they don't really impact you to such a degree that they should. It's not a terrible movie. I mean, it is rather entertaining at points. I do feel that even at 100 minutes, though, it was a tad too long. It was a little too slow. It didn't really gain the momentum that I hoped that it would. I think they could have cut a good 15 minutes out of this, and I think it would have played a lot better, and it might would have had a little more impact, a little bit more of what they were actually going for, but instead it's kind of just a bundle of somewhat interesting ideas that never really fully tie together. You know, as you're watching this movie, being that it is a thriller, you know, you're seeing all of these kind of seemingly random events occur, and you're looking for things to connect the dots, but in the end, there's a lot of things that don't really connect. And I just feel like Chloe's motive that spanned the entire film, it didn't really have justification. I didn't really buy that someone would spend all of this time doing all of this, but then again, I'm not psychotic. I'm not gonna give away what it was, but it just kind of seemed to me like what she was doing was utterly pointless in the end because nothing was really achieved. In the end, California Scheming is not a bad film. It's just kind of a mishmash of half-hearted ideas with a couple of interesting things thrown in. But ultimately, it lands a little bit flat, I hate to say. I wanted more out of this movie. I do think a good movie could have been there, but instead, it's just kind of disheveled. It doesn't really have much of a structure. And these kind of movies rely on structure. That's what a thriller is. It's supposed to be a sequence of events that a lot of times are seemingly random, and then whoa, in the last act, we're hit with a mind-blowing revelation that ties them all together that was under our noses the entire time, but the movie was too good and we never saw it coming. This movie doesn't really get there. I ultimately cannot recommend this movie. It's not worth the price of admission that you would be expected to pay at the box office, and it's also not worth what they are charging on demand for the movie currently. If the movie's price is reduced in the future, which I'm sure it will be when it actually has its home video release, it might be worth checking out then, just if nothing more, out of curiosity. Ultimately, though, I think this is kind of a Redbox thing. If you see it in Redbox and you're bored and there's nothing else to watch, you know, you're going to cough up $1.50 for it, I don't think you'll feel like you wasted your money because your expectations won't be that high. But when you cough up $20, $30 for you and a couple people to see it at the movie theater, I do think you will be pissed. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, comment below if you've seen the movie, let me know what you thought of it. I would love to hear other perspectives on it, and if I'm completely off base on this thing, I would love to hear reasons why you enjoyed the movie. And always remember, the only way Hollywood is going to stop making bad movies is if you stop paying to see them. I'm Devin Cartwright, I'll see you next time, and this was Bashing Hollywood.